Hey everyone, it's Rachel. In this tutorial, I'll teach you how to blend realistic skies using the Color Therapy app. For this tutorial, I will focus on a sunset or sunrise and show you how to layer clouds and color the sky with a variety of brushes. Okay, so here's my reference. So since I want to do either a sunset or a sunrise, it's going to make all of the foreground trees and everything black because they're going to be a silhouette. So really just going to be focusing on the sky and all the color up there. So here's the image that I chose for this. So you want to first start off by making sure your coloring inside the lines mode is set to off. And let's open up our color palette. Let's go over to the sunrise palette. So I'm going to set that to solid and select a combination of colors. So I'm going to choose some purples, some pinks, some yellows, some greens, and some light blues and aquas, as well as different shades of oranges. Let's start with the airbrush, size 100 and opacity at 15. First, I'm going to start off with sort of a medium orange and just spray across the horizon, keeping below the bridge. And I'll also use a deeper orange as well at the bottom. Then move on to a warmer yellow and just add another layer right above that, going all the way across, kind of blending that in with the orange. Then use the light green and an aqua as another layer above that. And then you can bring that light aqua all the way to the top. And now we have a nice gradient of all the colors. Let's add in the clouds now. Select the smudge tool. Set the size to 35 and the opacity at 100. Now let's add in the clouds with purple, yellow, orange, and pink. So I'll start off with this really bright purple and I'm kind of just like scribbling across the sky here and there, leaving a few open spaces and mostly just keeping towards just mostly above the bridge. And then I'll add the next color, add some pink in there. You can kind of do a little bit of a dotting action as well. So make sure you bring all the way across the image through the trees. And now I'm going to use an orange. And just continue doing that. Right now, I'm kind of focusing on the oranges and pinks sort of near each other. And I'll use a little bit of yellow too, below the pinks. So you kind of want your gradients between each cloud to sort of blend going from light to dark. So it will be a purple going into a pink, into orange, into yellow. You can add a bit of movement with your clouds too, by bringing some down and then some kind of curving up so you can angle it a little bit as well. And then with sort of a pale purple, I might just do a little bit of a cloud down here closer to the horizon. Now let's use the smear tool. I would set the size to about 20% and opacity around 60. And you can just kind of blend in the clouds here and there. If you want to give it a bit of movement in the clouds, you can smudge and pull up and down in the clouds at an angle. So it looks like the clouds are really wispy. Now let's open up the flat brush. Let's set the size to 25 and the opacity to 60. And now just go add in another layer. So I'm gonna just add in some details and I'm kind of going to do some up and down squiggly motions. And I'm using the same colors as before, just layering them. And I'm also gonna add a bit of white and the white will go right underneath where the yellow is. So it looks really bright from far away. So just do an angled scribble motion for this, and that adds in another layer of dimension to your clouds and texture as well. So just add it where you want. Might add some brighter yellow orange too from that same palette. And then let's smear it one more time. This time let's set the size to 10 and the intensity at about 40%. And now let's just add in a final smear into the clouds here and there just to really blend that nicely. And I'm just doing it again, just in a few areas. So as you can see, it's pretty simple, actually. And the last step is just to tap to fill everything in with the black, and then you'll have a nice silhouette. Remember to also color in the reflection on the water, though it doesn't have to match it perfectly. And you can add elements like fog for an interesting landscape. If you'd like to see more tutorials like this, don't forget to subscribe to the Color Therapy YouTube channel so you don't miss any new tutorial videos. Thanks for watching our tutorial. You can get the Color Therapy app for free on the App Store.